What is up, Pats Nation? It's Patriots Global back here with another video, and in this one, I want to break down Patriots' newly acquired offseason addition and wide receiver Damiere Byrd, and really just where does he fit in with the Patriots, and what should Patriots fans expect from him heading into the 2020 season? Now, in this video, I'm not going to break down too much about Damiere Byrd and kind of just his profile here because I did make a video on him when the Patriots signed him as a free agent. So if you want to know more about him, where he comes from, his strengths, his weaknesses, go ahead and check out that video. But currently, the Patriots have Damiere Byrd under a one-year contract. So basically, that means that in 2021, he will be an unrestricted free agent. He's currently 27 years old, sits at 5'9", 180 pounds, but he is going to be that speedster that Patriots fans have been dying to have. You know, everybody talks about Brandin and missing that speed. Well, ironically, Phillip Dorsett and Brandin Cooks both had that same 40-yard dash time, a 4.33. Damiere Byrd is faster than both of those guys. In his 40-yard dash, he ran a 4.28. So if you've been looking for that Brandin Cook-esque type player, a guy who can take off those end-arounds, a guy who can stretch the field and be a threat in the long run, then this is going to be who it is. Throughout his four-year career, joining the league in 2016, he's been a guy that really has not been talked about, but he is, luckily enough for the Patriots, coming off of the best season in his career. Now, the first three seasons, he was in the league from 2016 to 2018. He was a part of the Carolina Panthers. The stats just weren't really anything crazy. 2016, he only played one game and had just 16 yards. In 2017, he appeared in 8 games for the Panthers and had 105 yards. In 2018, he appeared in 8 games again, but only had 8 yards. And then in 2019, he had signed that one-year deal with the Arizona Cardinals, and it proved to be the best fit, at least so far for him throughout his NFL tenure. He appeared still in just 11 games, so that's something else to add is the fact that he has not appeared in a full season throughout his entire time in the NFL. I don't think that's more so injuries. I think that's more so based off of scheme fit and kind of, all right, who's going to make the final day roster? But this past season, when he appeared in those 11 games, he was targeted 46 times with 32 receptions for 359 yards, averaging 11.2 yards a reception and one touchdown. When I look at his stats and I go, you know, more in depth and I'm looking at more specific points than just receptions and yards and touchdowns, and I'm looking at yards per reception, he's been a guy that proves to be able to stretch the field. In his first year in the league with the Panthers, he averaged 16 yards per reception on that year. 2017, he averaged 10.5 yards per reception on that year. Now, in 2018, it was only 8, but of course, that was also the same season. He only had a total of 8 yards. And then this past year, in 2019 with the Cardinals, he averaged 11.2 yards per reception. This past year was also the longest catch he has ever had in his NFL career with a 58-yard reception. I feel like in order to talk about the expectations for him heading into the New England Patriots, which is just a totally new environment for Damiere Byrd, we have to kind of talk about what was it like for him in 2019 with the Cardinals? How did they utilize him? Where did he rank from their other wide receivers? So like I mentioned, he had signed a one-year contract deal with the Arizona Cardinals for just a $720,000 one-year contract. He was able to make the Cardinals' final roster and ended up being the third wide receiver on that depth chart behind Larry Fitzgerald and Christian Kirk. Now, during the 11 games that Byrd was playing with the Arizona Cardinals this past season, during the regular season, he was on the field for just 43.4% of the Cardinals' offensive snaps, which was just 455 out of 1,048. So that just goes to show the fact that, look, when he was in the games, because let's again remember, he played 11, not a total of 16 games. And when he wasn't a guy being totally utilized. He didn't even get to play half of the snaps. So I think that this is just already the type of signing when you look into the stats and the facts that he really isn't being given too much of an opportunity. He's not being given a chance to play a full season. You know, this past season was the most games that he's ever played. And even when you look at the amount of snaps he played, he wasn't even able to play 50% of them. I'm just curious to see what it would look like if Damiere Byrd was able to play, let's just even say 60% of offensive snaps, but playing a full season. When he was on the field, he was a guy that mainly played on the perimeter of the field, wasn't really working through the slot and the middle of the field. Now, for the Patriots, I do expect that to mainly be the same thing, but when I look at this guy's build, I look at his speed and I kind of look at what other teams have done with guys who have speedy wide receivers. Let's talk about Tyreek Hill with the Chiefs. When you talk about Brandin Cooks in his time with the Los Angeles Rams. Any of these other fast receivers you can name, a lot of times we are now seeing them play in that slot, playing in the middle of the field. Now, that does not mean that they are primarily just in that slot position, playing in the middle of the field, because, you know, of course, when you look at Tyreek Hill, you look at Brandin Cooks, they do get time on the outside, but the league is kind of changing in this way of they are trying to create mismatches in the league now by putting that fast guy working throughout the middle of the field, and that is something that I could really see the Patriots doing here with Damiere Byrd. Now, of course, the Patriots do have a lot of other guys who are in that slot position. You do have Julian Edelman. You do have a guy like Will Hastings, if he does make the roster. Jacoby Myers. But, again, let's remember that if Damiere Byrd does make the roster, he's not a guy that always has to play in the slot or always has to play on the perimeter. And when you look at a guy like Julian Edelman or Jacoby Myers, those are guys, too, that don't always have to be specifically playing in the slot. They've been able to work on the perimeter and have had success at doing so also. Now, Byrd was also a part-time kickoff returner when he was with the Cardinals this past season. He wasn't the full-time guy, but he did get some looks. He was able to add a total of 59 more yards to his total yards on the year, in which he averaged 14.8 yards on 4 runbacks. Now, to me, those stats definitely do not dictate the talent and the ability that Damiere Byrd has. Let's also remember the supporting cast he has. I mean, are you trying to tell me that the blockers that he has on a kick return are going to be anything compared to what the New England Patriots have? I mean, even when he was with the Carolina Panthers, they had better blockers when he was a return man. With the speed that Damiere Byrd has and having the blockers and the special teams unit that the Patriots have, this could be the best fit that he has had, at least in a special teams aspect. You know, if he's able to make his name heard and he is able to make this final 53-man roster, then I think that he is going to get a higher workload, an increased workload than he has had over the past few years in his NFL career. But to me, that doesn't create a concern, because this past year when Damiere Byrd got an increase in his workload, he only did better. I really just feel like this is a situation where it all comes down to chance. What kind of chance is he honestly being given? Let's also remember that the Cardinals also have somebody like Andy Isabella, who is also a speed wide receiver. Damiere Byrd will be coming into a Patriots organization where they don't have anybody like Damiere Byrd. They don't have a fast guy who is able to get open because of his speed, who is able to stretch the field and get down the field fast due to the speed he has. So while he is still going to have to fight for a roster spot because he's not a 100% lock, it's not like he's trying to beat anybody out because nobody compares to the ability that he has. What I expect him to do ultimately is take over that Phillip Dorsett role, fill in that X receiver a type of mode with the New England Patriots scheme. Things clearly did not work out too well with Phillip Dorsett. Sometimes things seemed to be really great, and then it just seemed like other times Phillip Dorsett was just highly inconsistent. I think that Damiere Byrd has a chance to come in and be a more bona fide version of a Phillip Dorsett. you haven't seen too much of Byrd, but when you really dig in and you try to find his game clips, when you do your research on him, you find out that he's a guy who is really going to be able to stretch the field, I believe even better than Phillip Dorsett because he is a faster version, but also has really good hands and he's able to make so much more catches than just being a downfield threat. I think that the big thing that is going to separate him though from everybody else and could really push him forward into being a lock to make the roster is going to be the special teams value. Now, when he was with the Arizona Cardinals, they did shy away from using him on special teams outside of those six snaps during week two. But again, he does bring some experience in the kicking game, which of course the Patriots could use. He did run back only 26 combined kicks, 14 kickoffs, and 12 punts since entering the league, but he did find some success in both roles when he was with the Panthers as he returned 10 kickoffs for a combined 294 yards, which was 29.4 yards in average, and a touchdown, and also averaged a very impressive 9.4 yards on 12 punt returns. Now, as I am saying this, Patriots fans should definitely limit their expectations for him. Don't think he's going to go out there and compile 800 to 1,000 yard season because I don't think that's going to happen. He has been mainly put on the perimeter. That's where he's had found or has found his most success. But again, when you look at the Patriots, to come into the Patriots organization, they're going to push you to do different things. They're going to push you into being more versatile. And I don't see why Damiere Byrd would have any issues with it. And I think that he's just kind of that type of player who would be all for it as he tries to carve himself a role, essentially the first time in his NFL career. As for where would he rank among the other Patriots wide receivers, clearly he's not going to be number one. He's not going to be number two. I think that those spots are clearly filled by Julian Edelman and N'Keal Harry, but he has a chance to really take on that third to fourth wide receiver spot. Again, kind of like what Phillip Dorsett had taken over, but it's really all going to be dependent on him and what is he able to do and showcase to the Patriots during these virtual offseason programs and of course when training camp comes back and preseason. But that is going to be it for today's video. What are your guys' thoughts on the offseason addition of wide receiver Damiere Byrd? And what are your expectations for him heading into the 2020 season? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below and like this video if you guys have not already. It helps me and the channel out and the videos so much and it costs you completely nothing. Make sure you guys consider subscribing to the channel for all of your New England Patriots news if you haven't already. And like always, thank you guys so much for watching.